we're back in the saddle again. Welcome back. Well, to start off, I've been asked my favorite memory of Upper Perk. And lucky enough, you're all sitting here. You are my favorite memory. I have never imagined that I would be lucky enough to work with such dedicated, professional, creative, and caring people. I feel blessed to have been in your company.
Hi, everyone. I think about memories, and I have so many wonderful memories of Upper Perk. Memories as an Upper Perk student myself, as a parent of two Upper Perk students, and as a teacher. And among those fond memories are taking students on a trip to Colorado for an archaeological dig, and probably most important, forming so many amazing relationships with my fellow teachers, my students, and my parents.
Hey everybody, Keith Lehmer here. Just want to thank Dr. Rhodes for having me on here. A little bittersweet, I would say. For the first time in 38 years, I'm not sitting there with everybody on the first day of school. First question that I want to go through is some favorite memories of Upper Perk. You know, being there for 37 years, been through a lot. First thing that pops into my head is family. You know, when I first got there back in 1984, it definitely was a family, and everybody from administration all the way down through had everybody's back, and it was this amazing way for me to start my career in education and coaching. And I told this to Dr. Roach last year that I can really see under his leadership and the rest of our administration that we are getting back to that family type atmosphere. And it's awesome to see. And I really saw it, you know, this past year and a half, you know, with COVID when we were home on, you know, virtual learning, you know, and then, you know, going to hybrid. And when I got back to Hereford in January, I was so proud of Mrs. Avedil, Mo Zavedil at Hereford and my Hereford buddies there that, you know, you could really feel the family and the love, and everybody had each other's back. It was really amazing. Some other memories from over the years, back in, I think it was in the 1990s, Coach Hans's wrestling team was going for a state championship, and we were out at the Hershey Giants Center. And they were down to in the semifinal match, the last bout they were losing, and they had to win that match to get to the state final. And they were down to the last couple seconds, and Chris Sheets did a flying takedown to win that match. And they went on to the finals and won the state championship, and the place was rocking. That was awesome. It was a great experience for our school and our school district. My last day at Hereford this year with the students, they had Dressed Like Mr. Lehmer Day. And a bunch of students and staff dressed like me. And I'll never forget, I was out at parent drop-off. And this little boy gets out of his parents' car. He's got black Nike sneakers on, black socks, shorts with two lanyards hanging out of his pockets, and a t-shirt that said, "Lehmer Line, Lehmer Laws, Lehmer Rocks." I will forever remember that. Those are my favorite memories. I have a ton more, but I'm going to try to keep it short with that. So we're going to move on. So we are UP.
Hey, good morning or good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back. And I just want you to know that I'll be missing you all as you start your new year. As I think back to some of the memories that I have of Upper Perk, it's been so great. It was so great working with the kids and working with the parents, and just when you looked into their eyes and saw those light bulb moments, or when they discovered something or realized something, I think those are some of the memories that I'll remember the most, as well as the wonderful relationships with staff, with parents. So that's something that has meant a lot to me over the years. The other thing, as I look back and think about my years in Upper Perk, one of the things that will always be a big part of my life is how the staff was so helpful when my husband was sick, and that whole year that I was teaching, and he eventually passed away at the end of the year. It was just so wonderful how the administrators, staff, teachers just rallied around and just provided so much support. So that's something that I'll take with me forever.
The best thing about Upper Perk was teaching elementary kids, which I did for 33 years, loved those little kids so much. That obviously was the motivation behind my entire career. And I especially loved teaching Pennsylvania history while I was in fourth grade as a teacher. So that would be my favorite thing. Couple great memories would be my colleagues, my team, my awesome fourth grade team and former teams at Marlboro. You guys got me through everything that was so difficult, and I hope I helped you. The relationships with colleagues, that's going to go on forever because I won't be able to talk to all my students forever. But you guys, I'm in your lives forever. So was when Upper Perk won the Blue Ribbon Award back in the early 90s, and the school board took the entire staff to Washington, D.C. for a big fancy ceremony, and we toured the White House and had dinner at the Inner Harbor. That was awesome. I also had a really fun celebration in 2000 with my very first class that I taught. They were first graders when I began in 88, and I invited them back to my classroom in 2000 when they were graduating. And my current class, we had like poems and little songs and stuff prepared for them. And it was just so great to see my first class and hear what their plans were. So that's always a special memory.
Keith Lehmer's closing of his many, many 35 plus years in the district, he had his head shaved and the beard taken off. And there were children around him, students, and those students were chosen by their peers to watch this event. And then they went over Lehmer laws and stuff like that, which are very positive and respectful and kind of rules to follow in life. So Keith Lehmer, amazing, amazing, amazing guy. And he'll be surely missed from the district. For me, since I'm medical, I just wanted to mention, I had in my first year here of 2018 and 2019, I had to call the ambulance. Crystal Bittner from the office, the secretary there, I had both my students at different times were in trouble, and I called her in. She was my part of my team to kind of cover things when I had to just take care of the student for a situation. So I'm looking at her, and at the time it wasn't funny because, you know, I wanted to get this child into an ambulance, and I'm looking at her and she's on the phone, and I'm there like, you know, I go like, and she said, I'm on hold. I'm like, you're on hold trying to get an ambulance here. I thought that was really funny, but not at the time. But everything went successful, like I said, and the parents were great, and all was good with that. As for a final note for good memories, it's just the students. They are amazing.
Good morning, Upper Perk Yeoman. I'm Mike Swartley. I retired as the computer tech at the high school last year. I will say I thoroughly enjoyed seeing our work from the technology department supporting the classrooms, deploying the one-to-one, the CAD software, the 3D printing, the statistics software, specifically Mr. Kunkel's class, and much of the lab software in the science class was especially rewarding. Nobody had to say they liked our work. I could just observe it.
Hi, welcome. So what's the best thing about Upper Perk? Well, Upper Perk is comprised of caring, hardworking staff and community whose priority is the students. Students are number one. From support staff to professional administrators, all play a key part in the student's success. We are family. I used to feel how lucky many of you are who had direct contact with students, but I knew my staff and I helped to provide the tools you needed. On my last day, students from Shane's program that help in all the buildings came and gave me a hug. And one wanted to stay brought tears to my eyes. At Upper Perk, we all make a difference.
Run! Run as fast as you can! You have 30 years of hard labor ahead of you. You would have an easier career mixing cement. But if you have your mind made up and you want to stay, I will share some things. Don't get behind. The second thing, there are no bad kids. I know you dig deep for every child, but there are going to be those days where you get another gray hair And for those kids, you need to dig deeper because they're the ones that need you the most.
In the past week, I've been watching three of my four grandsons preparing to start school. And the look of excitement and hope that they have in their eyes shows me just how important your job is. No matter what grade level you're at, every teacher is so important to those students. And so many young students are counting on you, especially this year. You make such an impact on their lives. You know, we often don't see or hear it, but it's out there. And I want you to remember that I hear it all the time, how much we appreciate teachers. And I think I hear it more now that I'm retired than I did when I was a teacher.
First thing I'm gonna say is be positive. You know, smile. It's easy to smile. You know, let everyone know that you care about them. You know, when you see your students in the classroom or in the hallway or your fellow teachers and administrators, you know, make them feel like they're special. Make them feel like it's the first time that you've ever seen them. Second thing is be flexible, especially during these challenging times. You know, we went through the challenge of switching to online learning at the end of 2 years ago, and then to, you know, fully virtual come this past fall, and then into hybrid. So just be flexible. Help find solutions, because remember, if you're not part of the solution, you could be part of the problem. So make sure you're being flexible. Be a sponge. Young bucks, young teachers, and veterans alike, learn from each other. This is what got me through 38 years of teaching. And, you know, being an old person, I guess I could say, these last year and a half, I had to rely on the youngsters to get me through this last year and a half. And I am forever indebted to them for getting me through the virtual part of it and teaching this old dog new tricks.
So a word of advice as you start the new year, I think the things that will probably be most important this year with all of the uncertainty is, I can think of two things. One is not losing your sense of humor with each other and with the kids. And also, I think, also just letting them know how much you care about them, how much you love them. And I think that they will be really happy to know and be in the environment where they can see that you really do care about them.
First of all, you're such a dedicated group, and all the departments hustle together to make it a successful school year. It's not just one group is more important than the others. Everybody, teachers, custodial, secretaries, paras, food service, all working together to make this a successful district is what's going on with Upper Perk. And I'm excited to have had a part of it in my life.
Best advice would be to lean on your team. You need to gel as a team, get together outside of school and socialize as a team, because that carries back into the classroom when you have your PLCs. And I just don't know what I would have done without my team, my awesome fourth grade team. You guys just helped me get through everything. So leaning on your team is so super important. And then the other thing I would say is listen to your students. Everything they say matters so much, no matter how insignificant it might seem. Just listen to their words and respond to them, because they actually spoke up and said something. So everything they say, everything everybody says matters.
Think of something that you like to do. And with that, this is my new office. Following retirement, I started working for L.L. Bean at Lake Nockamixon, and today I teach introductory kayaking there and the sea kayaking classes. I did take the American Canoe Association Level 1 kayak instructor class, and I recently got certified. So, life is okay. Plan it well. Enjoy these years.
And the very final note is I have to say thank you. And I'm going to cry, but that's okay. First to Dr. Roach, who took over in 2019, and then COVID hit in 2020, and he has always had an open door policy for his staff, which is amazing as a superintendent. And then course, Principal Savadel, who her and I had some classes together at Lehigh, and I admired her then, and I admire her as a principal, and she has always been fair, and I've been thankful for her to be with her in the school. And another thank you to Crystal, Kathy Hill, Amanda Goda, and Lisa Tesseria, who are all secretaries in this school district, who has made my life and so many others easier to move forward, because they are like the radars from MASH. They know what's going on, they know what needs to be done, and I am thankful and grateful to them. And of course, my nursing buddies. The year would not have been as good if we all, as the nurses, didn't chip together, hang together, work through the frustration, work through being tired. Just we're a phone call away from each other to get problems solved with this COVID situation that added to our day. And that's it. I wish you well. You're going to have a great year. Peace out.
Retirement? I'm not going to lie. You have a lot to look forward to. No alarms, morning coffee at your leisure, traveling, spending time with grandchildren. But honestly, 35 years, it just flew by. And your time is right around the corner. Have a great year.
Every day I wake up is a snow day. How cool is that? So get back in the saddle again, bring your best, and knock out another year towards retirement. May the force be with you.
But I want to let you know about a recent event. So the Saturday before my retirement, which was just like 2 or 3 weeks ago, I met a woman at an Iron Pigs game. And she recognized my name for some reason and continued to tell me how her 3 children successfully went through Upper Perk and how proud she was, and that it was the experience, it was the instruction, but it was the staff and all the people they had contact with. She currently works in a district where the staff changes, and they don't have those relationships with their students as we do at Upper Perk. So be proud. Have a great year. We're all in this together. I'll be from afar, but always be thinking about Upper Perk. Upper Perk proud. Thank you.
You know, believe it or not, there are a few aspects of the job I won't miss too much. blanket and report cards. But mostly I'm going to be missing my colleagues and have a little bit of FOMO even on the first day that you guys all go back. I'm going to be wondering what's everybody doing and where are they going out to lunch and all that fun stuff. But I'm excited to see what comes down the pike next for me.
I look at retirement equaling freedom. You get to do what you want when you want to do it. If you need a mental health day, you can take it without worrying about logging on to ASOP, or back in the day, some of us veterans had to call the secretaries and tell them what was wrong with us so that we could get a day off. And, you know, I had said this to Dr. Rhodes when we first started the Zoom today, that I'm still trying to stay in a routine. And my wife said the other day, you know what, relax, you're retired. You don't have a schedule. You can do what you want when you want to do it. Now, if your spouse is not retired, then just expect that you're going to get a honey-do list. You know, finally, I get to be a full-time football coach. I will be available for breakfast, lunch, dinners, but I am not available for substituting. If I wanted to substitute, I would have never retired. Because remember, I got paid to play for 37 years. I loved what I did, and I never worked a day in my life. So a good friend of mine, Sarah Goslin, said, we're not going to say goodbye. We're just going to say see you later. Because when you say goodbye, it kind of is like a final thing or an ending thing. So I'm going to say to you guys, have a great year. If you need me, I'm there for you. And I'll see you later. We are UP.
Hey, good morning, Upper Perk. Welcome back. First day of school. I'm excited. Got so excited this morning, jumped out of bed, put the vest on, put the hat on, ready for traffic. And my wife yells at me, says, hey, you don't work there anymore. So off goes the hat, off goes the vest, and I get to play basketball with my grandsons. Here's my basket, here's their basket. Guess who's winning? There's Jason, and that's Jimmy up in the end. He's a hot dog. Anyway, welcome back, guys. Hope you have a good year. Remember, you are the most important people in the building. The students, they've learned from you. Keep up the good work. Keep smiling. We'll see you around town.